This is a little cinematic FPV drone with a stripped down 4K 60fps action camera. It's called the ProTech 25 Pusher HD and the GoCam, both from iFlight RC. Huge thanks to those guys for sending over a sample unit. I'm Benjaminky from All Authentic, and let's see if it's any good. Let's first start with a few pros and cons, and I'll show you my favorite features and then a few areas of shortcomings that you should know. Now first up, this little ProTech 25 comes in an HD FPV model, which is one of my favorite things. I can use my DJI goggles and controller for easy binding, controls, and that Caddx FPV camera feed is fantastic. It has very good FPV range, plus the HD resolution and clarity of the camera feed into my goggles is so good. Now, I always rave about digital FPV, and besides that steep upfront investment cost, it's totally worth it in my opinion. So the digital FPV on this little guy is awesome. I love the pusher design. It's supposed to help, I believe, with prop wash and such with these little CineWhoops. It's fully protected in this durable and strong plastic body. I enjoy flying these little quads with small ducted props. It feels so much safer when flying around people and objects nearby. The peace of mind of just knowing that just in case a small little bump into a tree or wall or whatever, the chances of safety feels pretty solid.
Don't tell the wife.
On their website, iFlight says that it's low noise, but I'm not sure I agree there. Here's an audio sample for you. And it's actually a little loud and screechy. It's basically not the loudest quad, but it's definitely not the most quiet either. Now, even though this guy is little, it's still packing some power and punch. It can carry some stripped down action cameras. The iFlight just released this new ultralight 4K 60fps action camera that they partnered with Insta360 on. Now, I believe it's a 1R guts inside, and I also believe it's very similar to the Beta FPV SMO 4K released last year. It was a stripped down Insta360 1R as well. Now, since this GoCam is just like all the other Insta360 cameras, we have to process the clips. Now, their software is really good. There's mobile app, desktop app. Now, what's cool is we have the option to set our field of view. So check this out, from ultra wide, action view, wide, linear, narrow, FPV. I think that's one of my favorites. Let's play through that. So sure, it takes that extra step of processing the footage. It's a little bit time intensive, but it's not bad, and we get some really impressive results for such a tiny camera and drone. Wow, that looks pretty cool. Looks like there's a little bit of jello wobbles up there. All right, so there you go. You can set your ins and out points and scrub through the timeline, which is pretty cool. And then when you're all ready, you just hit export. I like to do ProRes 422 for best quality. It's exported as a 4K UHD. I kind of like remove grain and color plus sometimes. Set the file path and okay, and then it processes. Another trick is you can close that and then go ahead to the next clip and process that. Or if you select multiples, you can also batch export, which is pretty cool. Most of the shots look pretty good overall. There's a little bit of jello when I was flying outside, but it's been super windy around here lately, and that doesn't help when flying this little quad around. Which, by the way, a small quad like this, you can feel when the wind is pushing you around. It's definitely something to keep in mind when flying outdoors. The overall image quality is nice, good dynamic range and colors, the 4K resolution looks pretty great, and for anyone looking for an ultralight action camera on a small and safe cine drone, this whole setup could be a great option, especially for beginners. Oh, and all those farm shots are from the Boyd family farm up in North Alabama. Huge shout out to those guys for letting me fly around their blueberry trees and animal farm. The GoCam's powered off the LiPo battery, and the kit even comes with ND filters, which is a nice bonus. Now, I didn't get mine hooked up, but you can even connect it directly to the quad, and then through UART and Beta flight configuration, set your remote to control the camera. All right, and now let's try a little real estate test. How could this guy work with maybe shooting real estate tours or cinematic promo videos or whatnot? How does the camera look in low light conditions? It's nice and small and safe. It's a little loud. Let's go try tests and fly into my house. I tried a couple different export settings. This one set at 45 degree horizon lock, which looked like a medium crop in on frame for EIS. There's some usable clips here and there for sure. Now I also tried FPV option, and this shows more of that Dutch tilt and angles from the flying, but gives us a wider field of view, which is nice to have. Now for the big camera comparison test, I really like the Insta360 Go 2. It's it's super tiny and lightweight, actually almost half the weight of the Go Cam. It can be remotely controlled with this handy charge case. I can preview the shot in the Insta360 app, and it can be mounted in any orientation, and it'll keep that horizon locked and level while giving a wide field of view. Now here's some footage of that, both inside and outside, and I think I would actually probably go with the Go 2 over the Go Cam, just for that wider versatility. Now while I can't export 4K 60 like the Go Cam, I find that the 1440p still looks really good overall. Plus, I love that I can export both horizontal and vertical videos. These are perfect for my TikToks and Instagrams.
I have to figure out how to mount the Go on here for the comparison. These little mounts, well, they're too big. They're the standard sized fingers. These are the mini ones. I don't have a little converter, unfortunately.
A little too wobbly.
All right, it's not winning any awards, but kind of gets the job done, actually. Just squeezing the Go Cam in here. It's pinched in there. I can actually control the tilt, which is kind
of
cool.
Now, of course, there's much better ways of mounting the Go 2 on this quad, but that was my fast and dirty option. It's kind of funny when you see the nose of the FPV camera rise into the footage. Of course, you could always digitally tilt the camera angle afterwards, or change your field of view options, or just mount it better. The Go 2 has that internal battery, so no external power or cables needed. Plus, since it weighs less, I noticed I was getting longer flight times on the ProTek 25 as well, which is a great bonus to have. And funny enough, the price difference is much closer than I thought. The Go Cam G3 is about $270, the Go 2 is $300, only $30 difference. Now for sure, the Go Cam is gonna have its own unique benefits, like 4K 60fps, it's really awesome to have. I just don't think it's a true replacement for a naked GoPro processed through Real Steady. I actually made a whole in-depth comparison on those stabilizations in FPV. You can check that video out after this one. I tried both the 650 and the 850 milliamp hour 4-cell batteries from iFlight, and I'd highly recommend the 850s, I think. You notice a considerably longer flight times, which is worth it for that extra weight. The ProTek 25 Pusher is a ton of fun to fly, both indoors and outside. It's small and safe-ish, but still very powerful and zippy. It's an awesome way to carry around an ultralight action camera for those cinematic FPV shots. I love that HD FPV quality and range makes flying in the goggles so much more enjoyable. The Go Cam G3 is a pretty cool stripped down action camera. It's just a little expensive. I wish it was a bit cheaper in price. There's a little bit of that jello to be careful of though, like the small 4K mounted on the Beta FPV drone. Little dampeners could definitely help in that area. My affiliate links are down in the description if you want to support me in these kind of videos, and if you want to learn more about any of these products, let me know your questions down in the comments. I always try my best to respond, and I'll see you guys in the next one.